Holics Network 18, Mission Poshan, Bhavishya Roshan.
Time now to quickly get the last 20-minute trading calls going. Ideas that you can either buy today and then reverse trade on Monday, or sell today and then reverse it on Monday. Let's get going with Ashwani as well as Prakash Gaba. Ashwani, what do you think of the action so far and the BTST ideas?
It's clear that given the way large caps are moving, the large cap indices may not fall unless there is some trigger. But it's clear that mid caps, market breadth has hardly improved. So there does not seem to be too much out there. But couple of stocks, large caps, which look like they are making some sort of sustainable bottom. One is Maruti. That's a buy with a stop of 88.30. Target of 89.50. RIL is a buy with a stop of 9.20, target of 9.55. And Ashok Leyland is a buy with a stop of 1.48, target of 1.60. Basically, if you buy stuff which is near previous highs, you tend to do much better. Also, in terms of Bank Nifty, I think today was a good day to come off hard. We haven't done that even post yesterday's rally. So if you want to take something home, possibly Bank Nifty is a good index to take home. You could use stops maybe closer to 26,600 thereabouts, and maybe yesterday's rally will resume at some point.
Ashwani, sounded a bit cautious in terms of how much more the Nifty can go. But both at 230, and now you got more buys than sells. I mean, earlier you had two buys and one sell. And the idea seems to be buying what is doing relatively okay rather than selling what is down.
See, the idea is that you sell mid caps and you buy large caps. If you buy large caps and they go up, the index gets maintained. But behind the scenes, correction continues. So that way you may see the Nifty going to 10,900, but this mid cap carnage continues. So that way you have to be with the stronger large caps and short on the weaker mid caps.
Okay, all right. Prakash, your trades, are you going with buys or sells now?
Both sells. I'll go with Indigo as a sell. Looks like it can see a slight around 1160 zones, stop about 1200. And second is Tata Steel. That looks like a sell as well. Looks like a 550 is possible, stop about 567.
The shape of the market is at 10,700. Right now, we're still holding on to that level. The Nifty Bank is undoing a lot of its magical rise that we saw yesterday. Still looking at a cut of over 200 points on that index. Prakash, to take a couple of the stocks with you, any thoughts on IT now? It's kind of gotten a little forgotten. It was the sector literally when we were in April. Any picks? Would you look at adding anything now?
Yeah, I mean, I think the mid-cap IT continues to still offer a lot of value from two points to look at, Surbhi. One is that, the gap in terms of valuation, which historically has been there between large caps and the relatively smaller IT companies, has been quite wide, and for this time around, if you see the large caps have actually continued with or have started moving back to their earlier valuation stretches, whether it is a TCS or a Tech Mahindra or an HCL Tech, and maybe the likes of Infi and Wipro follow suit. But the mid caps haven't yet moved up, whereas there's been definitely a lot of EPS accretive changes in most of the business. And I'm saying case in point is a First Source, a Hexaware. You look at even something like KPIT, all of them have had some very significant improvements, which are trend setting, which are not one-offs. They've not been just because of some couple of good client wins. And I keep on talking about this theme within IT that's playing out so well for the likes of Emphasis, Hexaware, that the moment ownership changes to a P-backed management, it opens up the avenues to do a lot of data mining from the client relationship that the PE fund enjoys and start leveraging your core strength across this client set. There's one company that's yet to kind of get re-rated from that perspective. So Emphasis has done it. Hexaware has done it in the past. And I think this is something that you should look at actively for a 3 to 6 month kind of a thing. It won't be like, you know, that there is a catch up and in the next 2 weeks something will move up and go up. But yes, I'm quite positive on IT as a pack, but specifically for the mid caps, not for the large caps.
And we reported earlier, Nisha reported that VG Siddhartha, the Cafe Mind Coffee Tree. Day fame, is selling. He wants to sell between 5 and 10%. He thinks it's a good price. He owns 20%. So I don't know. I mean, if you can, he thinks it's a good price.
No, but it could be for investment in some other businesses. Anything. And
he resigned from the board of the company, yeah, saying that he wants to focus more on the coffee business.
Yes, that's. So I think that's the thought process. And he had acquired a huge chunk when Ashok Soota moved out of Mindtree.
Yeah,
who was one of the co-promoters. So yes, he acquired that particular part, which was beyond what he already owned prior to that. Mm. So, you know, going back to this theme that I was talking about, the name that I didn't mention, but I was referring to is Zensar Tech. You know, another company
the
that
Goenka
is,
Group.
Goenka, of course, also have the FSL ownership. Mm. And Zensar has a very unique business model. It's a very simple business model. Till now, they were not able to get into the bigger accounts. Mm. And some of the earlier, you know, businesses that they started doing and, you know, associations that they had with some of the big names has started getting them that awareness and that visibility in the market. So it's becoming much easier for them to get into newer clients and things like that. You know, so even if they nibble into the large clients, and remember, large clients don't necessarily make great margins. You know, it's just a good name to have on your roster. But business comes from profitable business comes from the mid-sized guys.
Sure. In other news, Surabhi, Manpasand is down 10%.
I was noticing just that, looking at stocks that are on the move. Once again, down circuit. What, the fourth day? I was on leave when, of course, the entire dance and drama started. It's probably the fourth day of
fourth
circuit.
Or fifth, fourth or fifth, maybe.
Yeah.
200. I mean, I think it's been falling from 450 or so.
Mm. So that story continues. 200 round figure on Manpasand Beverages. By the way, one stock that's on an interesting up tier is EIL. Maybe we should get that up for you. An interesting up move. Very, very sharp surge on EIL that is underway. There we go. Positive now. Ashwani, I don't know. Have you tracked it recently? EIL? Any interest whatsoever from a trading bent?
See, there's no interest in PSUs. All kinds of PSUs are dropping. This one was also coming off. Now that, you know, a bit of action on OMC is some short covering, I don't think there's anything great to look forward to.
And what a disastrous looking chart on this one. It's down 35% this year.
Yeah.
And I remember, was it Citi or someone a couple of months back saying that this is a great buy? And
all of these conversations happen when the next round of the CPSC ETFs, you'll see a lot of people talking about how great PSU stocks are to own. But anyway, that's a different debate for another time. Right now, let's welcome in Nimesh into the conversation as well. He's been, of course, looking at how dealers have dealt with this Friday. Nimesh, good to have you. So what's the verdict out there? This mid-cap madness is not ending. I mean, the start of June is not hasn't been particularly auspicious for mid-caps.
Oh, yes, Sarbiyan. I'll tell you what. Today, I'm getting a sense that there is no panic setting in the retail and H&I category as far as the mid-cap fall is concerned. So, you know, a whole host of reasons for that. Of course, you know, in the last couple of months, we saw this MF reshuffling because of which there was mid-cap pain. I guess today's pain is essentially because of the new stocks that got added by the exchanges last night to the ASM. You know, that means that there will be additional margins on those stocks. And of course, those stocks in T2T. So I guess that's the reason why there is a bit of margin call pressure as well. Of course, these stocks got sold out as well. So that was a key reason for today's mid-cap fall. And now there is this, you know, every day you're hearing a couple of companies where there are auditors resigning. That's also not helping the mid-cap and small-cap space. So that's clearly, you know, whacked out of shape. And now there is real pressure in the PMS performances of many of those, you know, erstwhile PMS fund managers as well. So that pain seems to be not over yet is what I'm understanding. So that is something to watch out for. In terms of institutional activity, still, again, very much mixed. But I believe there is some bit of buying into auto names now, post this strong auto sales number. But the big stock to watch is HDFC Bank. Today, there was a lot of hope of some buying for the FIs, but that has not turned out to be the NSDL and CDSL have failed to put the data on their exchanges. So now the hope is maybe on Monday you'll see the limit opening up and maybe you'll see some bit of buying in HDFC Bank stock. But today the pain is clearly in the mid-cap and small-cap, and it looks like now there is panic setting in from the retail and H&I category.
Okay, I mean, and Nimesh, just hang in there. Market is selling off 50 points suddenly. So there is a fresh leg down, which is materialized. 10,688 is where we are on the index. So large caps are selling off. Mid caps are still there, 1.4-1.5% lower. Bank Nifty is also maybe sold off another 10 basis points, but the Nifty sold off about 20 points or so, pretty quickly. 33 lower on the Nifty. 10,693 is where we are at. In the last, 5 or 7 minutes, there is a leg down which we've seen. Prakash, do you see this extending?
I think so, because it looks like what we've seen is an exhaustion up there yesterday. It was some kind of a trap, perhaps, that looks like. What's really important to see that it did not close about 10,740. That was important if it had to go up. So far, maybe a sluggishness, maybe a sideways move, sluggishness.
If you were a betting man, next week would be down or up?
Looks like it'd be down. It'd be sideways, basically. Sideways to a mile down. It won't be up. It looks difficult slightly.
Okay, all right. Prashant Prabhakaran is Senior Vice President and CEO of Yes Securities. He's joining us on the show. Mr. Prabhakaran, thanks very much for your time. From clients at Yes, etc., what's the feedback like? What's going on, especially retail clients on the mid-cap side? What's the feel like?
The feel has been pretty bad, Prashant. Needless to say, when you're stuck in mid-caps, which forms a sizable part of the portfolio of most of the retail clients, I'm not talking about the HNI in particular, you have pain that you have to go through. And we do not see this recovery in the mid-cap space at all coming in the near future. Our best bet is that a couple of quarters down the line is when you'll end up seeing some recovery coming back. Maybe once you have some inkling after your state elections gets over and you are on way towards your general elections. Till that point of time, there is going to be considerable pain. There is buying interest from HNIs, but everybody is waiting for the entire correction to complete its full leg of the rally. And the expectation again is that the large cap will also have some amount of fatigue and it will end up having a 5 to 6% correction in the next quarter that is there, leading up to the state elections. So you have more or less seen the top is what we end up believing as far as the markets is concerned.
Okay. Well, actually looking at the best performers of the week on the Nifty 50 pack, it's actually the OMCs. I mean, those stocks have done the best, 6-7% up on BBCL, HPCL. Ashwani, I mean, you haven't been sounding very convinced. Even yesterday, you were quite doubtful about the surge, the expiry surge that we were seeing. What's the approach now? Would you be willing to, let's say, short positions home over the weekend, even on the index, Nifty or Nifty Bank?
See, the problem is that we have these weird rules where HDFC Bank can go up 5% on one day and screw up everything. But you want this event to, you know, get out of the way before you act, because you go home short and Bank Nifty is up 500 Monday morning. So that's one of the issues we have to deal with. But overall, you can say that 10,700, 710, which was the previous high, that has failed. So that way, probably people are trapped on the upside. But the serious issue is on mid-caps, because if this fall continues, you will have those other, those 600, 800 point falls on Nifty Juniors, because how long can retail sustain their portfolios? So if the falls start to get 60, 70% and portfolios really start to bleed, then the problem will really start there. Large gaps, 200-300 points up and down on the Nifty can happen, but mid caps will go to the cleaners.
Mr. Prabhakaran, the other issue which we were highlighting earlier is essentially the issue of very steep margins, margin requirements, etc. You would have a sense, you deal with retail clients. Is that a big issue? Has that been a big issue?
Yeah. It definitely was a big issue, Prashant. Luckily, the regulators have postponed it by a month. We'll again have some set of discussions with the regulators, hopefully trying to bring some sense of stability into that space. You've got to understand that till now, the prerogative of collecting the exposure margin in the derivative segment was lying onto the broker. Exchanges have made it mandatory to end up ensuring that span plus exposure margin, along with ensuring that the M2M losses had to be collected in cash. That means that you need to actually collect hard cash to cover up for every M2M volatile, and the markets have been volatile continuously from February onwards. Now, if you have to collect in cash, usually leverage players do not have that amount of liquidity. They are coming out with clarifications, hopefully in the next 1 month, which will end up bringing some stability in. It is good to have extra margins, but brokers usually are very careful when it comes down to handling clientele funds and keeping it under control. So obviously, when extra margins are required, your volumes will get affected to that extent, because you need to add another 15-20% extra margin per client for the exposure that he's already holding in the market. So if he wants to roll over, he might not be able to roll over the full set of his exposures that he had. He'll have to reduce it at least by 15-20% to ensure that the extra margins that the exchanges and brokers are asking for are collected.
Okay.
So it was definitely a big issue.
It's been pushed down by a month, Prashant, where, I don't know, kicking the can down the road. Unless there are, you know, significant changes that the regulator proposes a month later. But we've got 4 weeks to get our heads around that. Just about a minute and a half to go before trade closes out. By the way, EIL continues its surge, 2.5% up. CG Power has also recovered quite a bit of the lost ground. But Prashant, I guess a good time to start wrapping up trade. Weekday, I think, I mean, Friday will go down as weak. And this elusive breakout that the bulls have been really hoping for, I think it's at least not this week. The wait gets longer.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I think the, you know, the, as I was saying, the market from what, 28th of March or something, which was essentially the low, I mean, has come up 250, 300 points, maybe even more. So the breakout already happened, and now you're just dealing with where we are. I mean, so for the week, the Nifty will basically be up about 0.75%, which is actually not a bad outcome. You look at the bank Nifty. I think the bank Nifty for the week will be up 1.5%. So again, not a bad outcome. And of course, we'll look at the sectoral changes, etc., in just a bit. So daily close for large caps. So Bajaj Auto, sort of really top of the list there. You know, Maruti Autos, basically. Bharti Airtel. You look at Hero, you look at Hindalco, you look at Tata Motors, ICICI Bank. These are, what, the seven odd stocks which end the day with gains of over 1%. On the downside, Aurobindo Pharma, I mean, it's back around the 530 odd mark. Aisha is down about 3%. You look at ONGC, which is down about 2.8%. Tata Steel is down about 2.6%. Mahindra and Mahindra down 2.5%. Gale down about 2.5%. So, you know, I count, what, 10 stocks on the Nifty large caps with losses of more than 2% each. And thankfully for bulls, I mean, what looked like the beginning of another leg of selling did not really materialize in a very big way. We lost about 20 points in the last 10 minutes or so of trade on the Nifty, but it kind of settled there. So the Nifty ends down about 49.85, so 50 odd points or so, and 10,686 is the Nifty close. The Sensex ends down about 132 odd points and 35,190 on the Sensex. Advanced decline, etc., pretty poor, 3-1. Declines to advances today, but mid-caps and small-caps.
What a story for mid-caps. You know, it's just auditor issues, scare about auditor issues, then heightened margin requirements, the surveillance list, and there's just too much going on. Plenty of red. Of course, these are some of the stocks that have managed to recover because they already got a drubbing yesterday. But yes, Atlanta down about 15%. Let's look at more names. GMR has ended down about 8% despite the clarifications that the company was giving. You just saw Manpasand on your screen down 10% again on circuit. Shankara is down about 9%. Shankara building projects. More names. PC Jewelers 6% on the way down. Some of the ADAG group stocks have been very weak. Reliance Nippon Asset Management. Check out this one. 7% down on Reliance Nippon. Then more names like Quality. Down about 10%. I mean, this has again been a very, very erratic stock from a price action point of view. So this is where the weakness was. We have seen Punj Lloyd come off. IRB was under pressure. Punj down about 7% thereabouts today. V-Guard has lost another 5%. It's a long list of losers out there. And then, of course, the stocks which were part of this ASM list, additional surveillance measures. So your Graphite, HEG, Venky's India, Tin Plate, a lot of these stocks have ended on the down circuit for the day, which is 5%, or very close to that circuit level. So, you know, lots of pain. Beyond that, Edelweiss, 5% on the lower side. Stocks like Allahabad Bank losing more ground. Andhra Bank, a lot of the PSU banks have been weak. CG Power cut its losses, but it's still going home with a decline of about 3.5%. On the upside, not much to speak of in the mid-cap universe. Mid-cap IT, again, in the search for quality, if I could say that. Perhaps First Source, 3.5% up. We saw some buying on a KPIT Tech as well. It's a couple of NIIT technologies as well. So mid-cap IT was largely the only island of green. Some buying on Torrent Pharma, EIL. Ashok Leyland and TVS Motors should be pulled up as well, because auto sales was the saving grace in terms of positive news flow today. So many of the auto counters have ended in the green. But otherwise, Prashant, I guess, mid-caps, I don't know. We wait for another day.
But, you know, for the week, I guess mid-caps pretty poor. Large caps
for the week, for the month, for the year, I can just rattle off numbers.
And I think this week should say a big thank you to HDFC Bank, because it, I mean, that was a big reason why we saw that. A large part of the reason was HDFC Bank, which was a very sharp up move, which we saw. So HDFC Bank is there. By the way, Monday could be another big day, as Nimesh was pointing out, and I don't think enough has been said about this. This morning, NSDL and CDSL uploaded essentially blank Excel sheets onto their website. It was not supposed to be blank. It was supposed to have the headroom available, but it was actually blank. And people were waiting all day for them to upload actually what is the actual headroom available.
How much can I really buy if I'm a FII?
And now, as Nimesh said in his link towards the end, hope is that that will be put on the website before market opens. And that was what Ashwani was referring to.
That's why he said, I'm not taking short positions.
If you sell Nifty and HDFC Bank is up 5%, that'll really, won't be good.
Okay, let's take final thoughts from all our guests then. Ashwani, if we still have you with us, any final word of advice for Monday?
See, on HDFC Bank, my sense would be that since it's known information, maybe it's already priced in. I mean, if I know that if FIIs can buy on Monday, the stock price will be higher, why will I not buy HDFC Bank today? So maybe yesterday's 5% took care of that. We'll probably see that on Monday. But it's clear that the easy trade is, if mid caps open higher, just get on to the short side. On the large cap, they'll still be up and down, and Reliance does well and HDFC does well. So maybe choppiness there. But mid caps should continue to fall, and beyond a point, I think even large caps will come off, because a few new variables have been added both globally and locally here. So chances are we could have a follow through on them.
Before we tell you what you can do with your weekend, here's some important news. Government officials have told CNBC TV18 that the Prime Minister's office has given its approval to future strategy proposed by a special task force comprising of the Ministry of Corporate Affairs and several other important members to curb the menace of shell companies. We have Timsi Jaipuria joining in with more details. Timsi, what can you tell us?
Well, as you rightly said, PMO has taken a review of status of shell companies, and not just this. This time, this task force, which made a presentation, which is headed by both Finance Secretary Hasmukh Adia and Corporate Affairs Secretary Injati Srinivas, they made a presentation to the PMO on action against shell companies. PMO has asked IT Department and ED to start sending notices to deregistered shell companies for under various provisions of IT Act and PMLA for recovery of tax dues. Now, remember, over 2.25 lakh new shell companies have been identified by the MCA, and PMO, on its part, has asked DFS and RBI to investigate financial details of frozen bank accounts, deregistered directors of shell companies as well. PMO, on the other hand, has also constituted a working group to probe about 80,000 shell companies, which are suspected shell companies right now. SEBI, MCA, ROC and SFIO will now also on the parallel begin a probe on the already identified 16,000 shell companies. Apart from this, now a new member in the task force, that is DG GST Intelligence, because government feels that they can use the data of GST to plug in the loopholes and get more shell companies under their radar. PMO has also given nod to a future strategy that should be in place soon, and they've endorsed the idea of the task force by saying that the future strategy could include that MCA will come up with a working definition of shell companies. Remember, there's no definition of shell companies right now, plus MCA will also begin a probe on companies having nil balance in their bank accounts, monitoring of data on the basis of a dozen of red flag indicators which have been suggested by various investigative agencies. Not just this, two crucial two crucial points here.
Sure.
Holdings above 10% in a company to be classified as significant beneficial ownership with mandatory disclosures. Mm-hmm. Also, a time-to-time review of various other policies. And yes, stricter KYC norms to be in place to know who are the directors, who are the direct and indirect beneficiaries.
Okay.
So overall, there's a whole host of things that government is now going to do to curb the menace of black money and shell companies.
Okay, all right. So the fight against black money continues. Thank you, Tim C, so much for that. Well, on that note, we take a quick break. On the other side, Manisha Gupta joining in with all the currency and commodity market action.